This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic. All right, we're going to use the technique of solving right triangles and a bit more algebra, including how to solve for two variables, to do this word problem. A surveyor is on a straight road to a mountain. He gets out of the car and measures the angle of elevation to the peak to be 42 degrees. He drives 500 feet toward the mountain, measures the angle of elevation again, and finds it is now 44 degrees. About how high is the peak? All right, so let's get a little picture of this, and probably my scale isn't going to look correct, but there's this road leading to some mountain. Let's just say that's the mountain. You know, there's the peak of the mountain. I know you could draw a mountain if you'd like to. So like maybe the mountain, you know, looks like that, but you know, you're just looking at the peak, okay? So there's the surveyor on the road. He gets out, let's say right here, and the angle of elevation there is what? He gets out and it's 42 degrees. Remember, it's always from the horizontal. Then he drives, what? Drives 500 feet, and he gets out again and looks up. It's 44 degrees. Now, it makes sense it should be higher in degrees, right? Because you're getting closer to the mountain. And this distance between where he originally got out when he gets closer is 500 feet. So we know this is 500. Now what we need to find out is the height of the peak. So how high is this? I'm going to call that H for the height of the peak. All right, so let's call this H, or you can call it M for the mountain, doesn't matter. But there's another distance here that we don't know, so I'm going to call that X. So this distance from here to here is X, which means the whole distance from this first time he got out is X plus 500. All right, so we really have two right triangles here. So I'm going to look at those separately. We have this 42 degree, and we don't know what H is over here, but how long is this base down here, right? The horizontal, it's X plus 500. And then we have this smaller triangle you see with the 44 degrees. And this is just X, that length, and this is H. So notice we've got two variables we need to find. Actually, we only need to find H, okay? But there are two variables in the problem. Okay, so let's see what we could do with this. Well, I can see that the tangent of 42 is the opposite over adjacent. So I could say the tangent of 42 degrees is H over X plus 500. And the tangent of 44 degrees is H over X. So we have two equations with two unknowns. This is a system of equations. So we could use the substitution method to solve this. Now, there's two ways of doing the substitution method. You could either solve for H and plug that in, or you could solve for X and plug that in to the other equation. Let's see, if I solved for H, let's say I solved for H in this second equation and plugged it in, I'd have everything in terms of X's, right? And I'd be able to solve. But just keep in mind, I'm not looking for X, I'm looking for H. So if you do that, you're not going to have the answer for H yet. On the other hand, if I solve for X, take this equation and solve for X, and I plug that in for X, I will have everything in terms of H's, and I'll have my answer for H. So there's two different ways we can go about solving this. I'm going to do it by solving for x first, and then we'll do it the other way, because let's see if we get the same answer either way. So I'm going to take this equation here, and if I want to solve for, I wanted to solve for h, because it's easy. I could just multiply both sides by x. So h equals x times the tangent of 44 degrees. So if I did that, then in place of h over here, I could put it in x tangent of 44 degrees over x plus 500. And you got to be really careful with your algebra here to solve these problems. Went a little bit too far here. Where are we? Okay. So we're trying to solve this. So the first thing I'm going to do is multiply both sides by x plus 500. So I've got tangent of 42 degrees times x plus 500. And when I multiply it on the right-hand side, I'm just going to be x times the tangent of 44 degrees. Now, be careful here. The tangent 44 degrees on the right, that's really just the coefficient of x. Okay, keep in mind, this is just some number, and we are not going to use a calculator and approximate it. We're going to leave everything just the way it is. But I'm going to distribute here. So I've got tangent of 42 degrees times x. And I'm going to write that in parentheses to get you used to the fact that that is just the coefficient of x. Plus, I've got the tangent of 42 degrees. This is really a whole quantity, right? Times 500. So I'm going to write that as 500 times the tangent of 42 degrees. That is just a number, and I'm going to write this as the tangent of 44 degrees times x. The reason I'm doing that, this is just like a simple problem, 2x plus 9 equals, 3x. It's really similar to that, right? Because tangent of 42 is just some number, 500 tangent of 42 degrees, that's just some number, and tangent of 44 degrees is just some number. So if we were solving this, you would just put the variables on one side and constants on the other. That's exactly what I'm going to do next. I'm going to subtract, instead of the 2x, I'm going to subtract this tangent 42 degrees x on both sides. So that will just give me 500 tangent 42 degrees on this side. Equals, actually, I need to write smaller, 500 tangent 42 degrees. 42 degrees is the same thing as the tangent of 44 degrees x minus the tangent of 42 degrees x. And we're going to combine like terms. So I've got the tangent of 44 degrees minus the tangent of 42 degrees. That's the coefficient of x. And so we need to divide both sides by that. So dividing both sides by that coefficient that's x. Okay, of course, we don't want to know what x is. We want to know what h is. So let's look back up here for a second. H, right here, let's see, h is x times the tangent of 44. So let's write that down here. Just keep in mind that h equals x times the tangent of 44 degrees. All right. So we want to know, so we know what x is, right? So let me write that out easier. Most people like to see it this way. 500 tangent of 42 degrees over tangent of 44 degrees minus tangent of 42 degrees. You're going to have to put that in parentheses when you plug it in your calculator, so I'm going to plug it in now. So that's x, but h is x times the tangent of 44 degrees. So H is X, which is 500 tangent of 42 degrees times the tangent 44 degrees minus the tangent of 42 degrees, right? That's X times the tangent of 44 degrees. So it's also times the tangent of 44 degrees. Wow! That's what you have to plug into your calculator. All right, so now we know what H is, and so the height is about, now, in my calculator, I've got 6659.36, so I'm going to say it's about, well, you could put 659 feet, that would be probably good, or if you want to round it up a little bit more, you could say it was approximately 6660 feet. You know, we're approximating here. All right, this is what I got in the calculator, 6659.367907. So, you know, rounded, it really is 6659. Now, some things to be careful of when you're using your calculator, you've got to be very careful. You need to put the parentheses around this 44 degrees and around the 42 degrees, okay, as well. I'm not going to do it the other way because that was a lot of work doing it that way. This is your math gal, Julie Harland. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where all of my videos are organized by topic.